beginning band spring concert. We're so excited to have you guys out here. We get to show off what we've been doing for this past semester. These kids, they've been playing in separate classes all year long, and they had their first mass practice today, the day of the concert, during 7th and 8th hour, and it went pretty well. And we're hoping that today, even with the excitement and energy and nervousness of performing in front of you guys, that it still goes well. Really quick before we start, we do want to remind you guys, please turn off your cell phones, or at least put them on silent. And if you have flash photography, please refrain from using flash photography because it can really mess up our performers. Also, please refrain from exiting the auditorium while a song is being performed, unless it's an emergency. You can usually leave between songs, and that's appropriate. Now on to the show. It's been an amazing year watching these students transition, and from not even knowing how to hold an instrument to being able to play what you're about to hear right now. And so it's been really exciting to see their progress, and that's one of the things I love about beginning band. We're going to start out our concert with a really strong song called Dragon Slayer, which uses some intense melodies and strong driving rhythm. But this is Dragon Slayer by Rob Grice. Side note here, and thank all of you parents that volunteered and helped out with that event. That event was a massive event, and the first time I've ever hosted it, and the parents that helped out and volunteered made it go so smoothly. So please, round of applause for those parents that really helped out. It's always nice to have support. These students played their solo in front of a judge, and that judge gave them a rating of a 1 to 5, with 1 being the best and 5 being the worst. This was the first time going to an event like this, and we're thrilled with the results of their hard work. This is the most I've had of any beginning band receive medals, so it's very exciting to see their progress and to see what they achieved. So, students, when I call your name, please stand, come to the front of the stage. Mom and Dad, get ready to take a picture if you know they did it, so you can snap one. But receiving a second division rating, and they only give awards and medals for people who make a first or a second division rating. So if they may lower than that, they don't get one, unfortunately, but they can try again next year. But receiving a second division rating on their solo ensemble are Ariana Dunham, Maite Cruz, Zechariah Alvarez, Jackson Siebold, Olivia Leischer, Osvaldo Ortiz, Jesse Gonzalez, Giovanna Martinez, Olivia McCollum, Peyton Pesnell, Sherlyn Diaz, and Sam Latrell. That's our second division rating people. Receiving a first division rating for their solo are Landon Holmes, Isaac Friend. Friend? I'm sorry, I failed. Okay, Kale Corbett. Adrian Caballero. Diego Rodriguez. Fatima Galdamez. Francisco Negrete. Hayden Allen. Italy Corona. Ina Harris. Isabella Machado. Kaylin Keen. She even had me practice before. Okay. Kevin Garcia. Leslie Lozada. We're gonna run out of room. Penelope Smith. Mr. Rohn's getting his work out. Camille McLeod. Erica Monroy. Caitlin White. Merlina Calderon. Natalie Ortiz. Daniel Ruiz. Michael Trujillo. Noah Abdullah. Romeo Ramirez. Tobin Potts. Aiden Zimmerman, Henry Woods, Olivia Davis, Samantha Whitaker, Zach Loin, Valerie Laguna, and that's our first division. Second division medalists for solo ensemble. Please give them a round of applause. that's an event we do every year, and next year, instead of just doing solos, they'll actually be able to do an ensemble, so they'll be able to work together with somebody else to do a duet or a trio, and it's a really fun event. And if they didn't do it this year, I highly encourage them to do it again next year, because it's a blast, and it's fun to be able to work on something that's completely outside of what we do normally in class. Okay, so up next, our next song features a lot of running woodwind melodies, which is supposed to represent little bugs crawling around. Sorry if any of you guys are afraid of bugs. You have the lumbering low brass that represents the bigger insects, like the tarantula or daddy long leg or something. And finally, we have the annoying pesky fly that just won't go away, represented by the trumpet section buzzing on their mouthpieces. The band finally managed to smash these bugs, followed by a familiar death song from Chopin's Funeral March. This is Creepy Crawlies by Michael Story. Before we play our next song and our last song, I would like to say a big thank you to all the staff and teachers that made it out to the concert tonight. If you are a teacher, administrator of Kirksey Middle School, would you please stand? I know, I'm sorry. Yeah, get back there. Okay, round of applause for them. It's always amazing to be able to, like, call on them and ask them for the support and pulling kids out of classes for big rehearsals and stuff like that. And they're so accommodating, and I really can't thank them enough for everything that they've done. Next year, these guys are moving on to Concert and Symphonic Band, and we are the only middle school in this region, not just in Rogers District, but we're the only middle school that does a Concert and Symphonic Band where we divide them up by ability level. And we do that because we were noticing that some of the students were kind of held back because they were really advanced and they needed that outlet of performing. And then I was also noticing that I had a handful of like eighth graders that were just not ready, and they were playing stuff that was really too challenging for them. And we've seen a lot of success with that. My eighth graders that are in our concert band this year have really grown a lot. They've become leaders in that group, and they've really stood out in a lot of ways. And then my seventh graders, who are in the symphonic band group this year, have really like pushed themselves. And it's been really cool to see their growth. And our goal is to make every one of these kids as successful as they could possibly be. And that's kind of our goal for that. So in doing that, our principals have really, really fought for us to have that type of program. And I can't thank them enough, because it's been something, it's been a dream of mine for a decade at this point in my band teaching career. Okay, so also, I want to give a huge thank you to what you see on the stage. This is basically from our superintendents and the school board. They voted earlier this year to give us a shell on our stage. And if you know anything about the way the band is supposed to sound, most of the time when they were playing without a shell, you couldn't hear half of the band. It just died on the stage. So if you could, please give them a gigantic round of applause for this. The nice things in life are unfortunately very expensive, but we cannot thank them enough for this type of gift for our band programs and our music programs overall. Okay, so our final song is the actual Kirksey Middle School fight song. I think it's labeled as On Wisconsin on your program. This fight song, I think this is the first year I've ever done it with a sixth grade group, and I'm excited to do it because next year, regardless of whatever band they're in, concert or symphonic, they'll be playing the song at a pep rally and different events and things like that. So we're very excited to show off our final song of the night. And thank you guys so much, parents, for your support. But here's our final song, the Kirksey Middle School fight song. Clear the stage and get their instruments put away, things like that. But guys, again, thank you so much for your support.